Myself, Dr. Ramesh Patel, welcomes you all on behalf of R.N.G. Patel Institute of Technology, Bardoli. Thanks for join in the live session. Today, we are going to conduct a webinar on unit processes in organic synthesis. Before the introduction of today's speaker, I brief you about our institute. RNGPIT offers a 2 bachelor degree. One is Bachelor of Engineering and other is Bachelor of Vocational Courses. Our institute affiliated to Gujarat Technological University, Gandhinagar, and approved by AICTE. As far as RNGPIT concerned, during this lockdown period, a series of webinars are arranged for the guidance and updation of students. So, today we have an eminent personality speaker with us, Dr. Paresh Patel. Sir is working as an associate professor, Department of Chemistry, Veer Narmad South Gujarat University, Surat, having qualification as a MSc PhD in Organic Chemistry from Veer Narmad South Gujarat University, Surat. Sir is having more than 20 years experience as an academia. Before joining to VNSU, Sir has worked 17 years as an assistant professor in Narmada Science College located at Bharuch. He has published 40 research papers in national and international journals and conferences. His research area of interest is dyes, drugs, polymers, and organic synthesis and its applications. Sir is also a research guide, and under his guidance, total 7 students are awarded PhD degree. And right now, 4 students are pursuing PhD degree. As we know today's scenario, sir, let acknowledge our students with your great experience. So I heartily welcome you, Dr. Paresh Patel, sir, and I request you now, sir, over to you. Please share your experience with our students.
Thank you, Amish sir, Dr. Amish sir, for nice introduction. And I'm very, very thankful to RNGIT Institute of Technology for inviting me in this webinar to share my views with the student engineering students. Thank you very much. Now, good morning, all of you. So, talk of today's webinar is unit process in organic synthesis. Now we know that first of all, we are going for the definition of unit process. Unit process is a synthetic step which is employed in industry of applied chemistry to manufacture various chemicals. As for example, nitration of benzene. So nitration is a unit process. Benzene to toluene. So alkylation is a unit process. So unit process is nothing but the synthetic step which is used in the industry, which is employed in the industry of applied chemistry to manufacture various chemicals. As for example, nitration, sulfonation, halogenation, hydroxylation, oxidation, reduction, carboxylation, acylation. These are the well-known examples of the unit processes. So let us start with the one examples related to the unit process. So conversion of benzene to paraphenylene diamine. So how to prepare paraphenylene diamine? That is most important, because paraphenylene diamine consists two reactive groups, and both these reactive groups are at the para position. So it is very difficult to synthesize this paraphenylene diamine.
Sir, your screen is not visible. Your PPT is not visible.
Just a wait, madam, please. Now it is visible, madam.
No, sir. You have to click on share screen. It is not visible.
Not visible. Now is it visible, madam?
No, sir. Your screen is not shared. It is not shared yet.
Sir, share screen માંથી તમારી PPT.
So you can start. Your presentation is visible. Yeah.
Yes, visible, madam. Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Now let us start the unit process. So unit process is a synthetic step which is employed in the industry of applied chemistry to manufacture various chemicals. As for example, benzene to nitrobenzene. So nitration is a unit process. Benzene to toluene. So alkylation is a unit process. So various unit processes are sulfonation, amination, halogenation, alkylation. hydroxylation, oxidation, carboxylation, acylation. These are the different unit processes. So let us start with the one examples of the conversion of benzene to paraphenylene diamine. Now, paraphenylene diamine consists both these reactive groups. So it is very difficult to introduce both this amino group at the Poiret position. So there are various routes to prepare paraphenylene diamine. So first route is from benzene. So first it is the nitration of benzene, and this nitration can be carried out with the help of concentrated nitric acid plus sulfuric acid to give a nitrobenzene. And these reactions can be carried out at 60 to 70 degrees centigrade temperature. Then we have to go for the reduce it into amino group. Why? We know that the nitrobenzene consists nitro group and it is a metadirecting group. So it is very difficult to introduce any nucleophile or electrophile at the para position. So we need to convert into an aniline. That is by reduction. So next step is the acetylation. So why we need acetylation? We know that amino group is a very reactive, in aniline is a very reactive. So we need protect the amino group, or we have to reduce the reactivity of aniline by acetylation. Next step is the acetylation to give acetanilide. Then nitration of acetanilide, and we know that again this anilide group is a very reactive. So this
sir, sir, you are not audible.
Diamine. Total, yes, 7 to 8 stages are steps are available, and nitration, reduction, acetylation, nitration, hydrolysis, reduction. These are known as well-known examples of the our organ unit processes. So this is the first route to prepare paraphenylene diamine. But industry point of view, it is not economical route. Why? Total 8 stages and we can't get more than 30 to 40% yield. So this is not economical route. So another route is also possible, that is from benzene. So first step is the chlorination to give a chlorobenzene, and then nitration of chlorobenzene to give a mixes of orthonitro as well as paranitro chlorobenzene, and separate paranitro chlorobenzene by fractional crystallization, and then go for the ammonolysis and reduce it to give a paraphenylene diamine. So this is the second route to prepare a paraphenylene diamine. Now in this process, first step is the chlorination, nitration, ammonolysis and reduction. So these are the unit processes to manufacture a paraphenylene diamine. So in this process, only one time ammonolysis and another one is reduction. So by using this process, we can get up to 50 to 60% yield. So this is the better one than previous one. So anyhow, nitration, sulfonation, chlorination, nitration, reduction, ammonolysis, these are the well-known examples of the our unit processes. So this is the definition of unit process. Now unit operation. Now what are unit operations? So physical changes connected with the industrial handling of the chemicals for the finished product or final product. As for example, we know that sublimation, evaporation, extraction, centrifugation, filtration, absorption, these are the well-known examples of the unit operation. So any synthetic or any manufacturing process is equal to unit processes and unit operations. So these are basically concerned with the manufacturing of any important chemicals. Now first unit process is the nitration. So now what is nitration? To introduce one or more nitro group into organic reacting molecule, that is known as a nitration. Now that nitro group may be attached to the carbon atom or nitrogen of amino group or oxygen atom. So anyhow, nitration is nothing but the to introduce a one or more nitro group into organic reacting molecule, that is known as nitration. So simplest example of the nitration is the conversion of nitrobenzene into nitrobenzene. So this nitration can be carried out with the help of concentrated nitric acid plus sulfuric acid to give a nitrobenzene, and these reactions can be carried out at 50 to 60 degrees centigrade. So anyhow, this is an example of nitration unit process. So now, nitrating reagents. So there are many nitrating reagents are available to proceed nitrations. So out of them, first one is the nitric acids. So we know that there are many types of the nitric acids are available. First one is concentrated nitric acid. Second one is the dilute nitric acid. Third one is the absolute nitric acid. And fourth one is the fuming nitric acid. Now, what about concentrated nitric acid? We know that nitric acid, how to prepare nitric acid? We know that nitrogen dioxide passes through water to generate a nitric acid. So in that one, the amount of NO2 gas is in excess. So that can be recognized as a concentrated nitric acid. What about dilute nitric acid? So NO2 gas is very less. The amount of NO2 gas is very less in that water. So that can be recognized as a dilute nitric acid. And absolute nitric acid means that may be the 100%, nearer about 100% nitric acid. And fuming nitric acid, NO2 gas is in excess in the absolute nitric acid. So first nitrating agent is a nitric acid, but there are many types of the nitric acids: concentrated nitric acid, dilute nitric acid, absolute nitric acid, and fuming nitric acid. So second type of the nitrating reagent is mix acid. So we can use a mix of nitric acid plus sulfuric acid. We can also use a mix of nitric acid plus acetic acid. We can also use nitric acid plus acetic anhydride. We can also use concentrated nitric acid plus phosphoric acid. We can also use nitric acid plus perchloric acid. So these are the mixes to proceed the nitration. Now, out of them, concentrated nitric acid plus concentrated sulfuric acid is a universal mixed acid to proceed the nitration. So why? So there are many reasons behind it. We will discuss later on. So acetic acid is also available. Acetic anhydride is banned item nowadays. We know that acetic anhydride can be used to convert morphine into heroin. And heroin is a CNS drug, so a banned item. That's why acetic anhydride is a banned item and is not available in a routine market. So we have to take a permission or etc. from our DSP office. Anyhow, out of all these mixtures, nitric acid plus sulfuric acid can be used as a universal nitrating reagents. So reason behind it, we will discuss later on. So another nitrating reagents are dinitro tetroxide, dinitro pentoxides, stable salts as a nitro tetrafluoroborane, nitronium perchlorate, nitronium hexafluoroantimonate, and nitronium pyrosulfates, and organic nitrates as a nitroacetates. So these are the different nitrating reagents to proceed the nitration reactions. Out of them, a mixed acid can be used to proper nitration. Why? We can also use only nitric acid, but what is the role of that sulfuric acid in a mixed acid? That is, with the help of the reaction mechanism, we can explain the role of sulfuric acid as well as different mixes. So what is the role of that? We will discuss in the reaction mechanism in the of the benzene to nitrobenzene. This is the simplest example of the nitration unit process. So reaction mechanism of the nitration involves three steps. First step is to generate nitroniamine. So how to generate nitroniamine? First one is reaction of nitric acid with sulfuric acid to generate nitroniamine. So here we know that nitric acid is an acid, sulfuric acid is also an acid. So reaction between acid and acid, which is quite difficult. but one can act as an acid and another act as a base. And we know that sulfuric acid is a stronger acid than compared to nitric acid. So what is the role of that sulfuric acid? Which can donate a proton to the nitric acid, and that nitric acid gain a proton to form a nitronium ion, hydronium ion, and from sulfuric acid, a bisulfate ion can be formed. So first step of this reaction, nitration reaction mechanism, is to form a nitronium ion. So the role of the nitric acid and sulfuric acid, the role of the sulfuric acid is a mixed acid to generate nitronium ion. We can use only nitric acid as a nitrating reagent, but with the help of that, we can generate nitronium ion, but we can't get the appropriate yield of that nitration reactions. So we have to mind saying only nitric acid can be used as a nitrating reagent, but we can't get the appropriate yield of the nitration. So that's why we have to use a mixed acid, and out of all the mixed acids, sulfuric acid is cheaper than all these things. And we can also use sulfuric acid as a solvent, as well as which can combines with the water molecule which is generated during the chemical reactions. And that's why a mixed acid, nitric acid plus sulfuric acid, can be used as a proper nitrating reagent. So first step of this reaction mechanism is to form a nitronium ion. And generally we know that nitration is a electrophilic substitution reaction. We know that what is substitution? One atomic group can be replaced or substituted by, can be substituted by another, can be substituted by nitronium ion. So that is known as a nitration reaction. So basically, substitution reaction, one atom or group can be substituted by another atom or group, that can be recognized as a substitution reactions, and that substitution can be carried out with the help of the electrophile. So that reactions can be recognized as a electrophilic substitution reactions. So we know that nitronium ion is a electrophilic, positively charged electrophiles. So nitration is a electrophilic substitution reactions. So first step of this reaction mechanism is to form a nitronium ion. Now, second step is the attack of the nitronium ion to the aromatic system. We are talking about the aromatic nitration. So first, nitronium ion, electrophile means it consists of deficiency of electron. So it attacks towards the electron center and to form a nitrobenzonium ion. So that nitrobenzonium ion, so here delocalization of the positively charged from one aromatic center to another aromatic center. It means delocalization of this positively charged, and that can be recognized by half dotted circle. So this indicates the delocalization of the positively charged from one center to one carbon to another carbon. So third step of this reaction mechanism is the deprotonation, and this deprotonation can be carried out with the help of the bisulfate to generate a nitronium ion. So this is the reaction mechanism of the nitration. It means nitration reactions can be carried out by three-step reaction mechanism. And we already discussed about the function of the sulfuric acid in the reaction mechanism of the nitration. It acts as a solvent for the reaction. It facilitates the nitration by reaction with nitric acid to form a nitronium ion. It also acts to maintain the strength of the nitrogen mixture by combining with water, which is formed during the reactions. So these are the three important parameters to act as a nitrating mixture, as a nitric acid plus sulfuric acid. Now, nitration of the next title is the nitration of the aliphatic compounds. Generally, nitration of the aliphatic compounds can be carried out at higher temperature than compared to gas-phase nitration can be carried out at a higher temperature. As for example, propane, nitration of the propane to give a mixes of 1-nitropropane, 2-nitropropane, nitroethane, and nitromethane. So these reactions can be carried out at 400 degrees centigrade temperature and with the help of this 70% nitric acid. So anyhow, this nitration can be carried out with at the high temperatures, and at that temperatures, the fission of the carbon-carbon to form nitroethane as well as nitromethane. Second type of the aliphatic nitration is the nitration of the acetylene, and this nitration can be carried out at 50 degrees centigrade temperature in presence of a mercury chloride catalyst, and total 6 moles of the nitric acid can be used to perform these reactions. So aliphatic nitration can be carried out in a gas phase as well as liquid phase nitration. Now, nitration of the aromatic compounds. We already discussed about the nitration of the benzene to form a nitrobenzene. Now, different factors affecting on the aromatic nitration. So first one is the temperature. First factor is affecting on the nitration is the temperature. We know that mononitration of benzene can be carried out with the help of the concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid at the 60 degrees centigrade to give a nitrobenzene. Now, if you go for the again nitration of benzene with the same nitrating reagent to give a metadinitrobenzene, but this nitration can be carried out at 100 degrees centigrade temperature. And then with the help of the same nitrating agent, if these reactions can be carried out at 150 to 160 degrees centigrade to give a 2,4,6 trinitrobenzene. Okay, so we already discussed the mononitration of the benzene can be carried out at 60 to 70 degrees centigrade, dinitration can be carried out at 100 degrees centigrade, and trinitration can be carried out at 150 to 160 degrees centigrade temperatures. So first factor is affecting on the nitration reaction is the temperatures. So we can increase the temperature, so we can get a mono to di, di to tri, nitro substituted derivatives of affecting on the nitration. Now, second factor is affecting on the nitration is the nature of the nitrating agent. Again, nitration of the benzene with the help of the concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid to give a metadinitrobenzene, and these reactions can be carried out at 100 degrees centigrade temperature. Again, if you go for the nitration of benzene, it can be carried out with the help of the fuming nitric acid and sulfuric acid to give a 1,3,5 trinitrobenzene. So if you go for the nitration reaction with the help of the same temperature, 100 degree, 100 degree, but if we use concentrated fuming nitric acid instead of concentrated nitric acid to give a disubstituted to trisubstituted derivative. So this is the second factor is affecting on the nitration reaction is the temperatures. Now third factor is affecting on the nitration unit process is the nature of compound to be nitrated, or we can say the functional group is present in the aromatic system. So we already known that nitration of acetanilide. Generally, we are carried out this experiment in our laboratory below 0 to 5 degree, at below to 10 degrees centigrade or 0 to 5 degrees centigrade temperature to give a mixes of orthonitroacetanilide as well as paranitroacetanilide. So these reactions can be carried out below 10 degrees centigrade. This is phenol. So nitration, mononitration of phenol can be carried out at 20 to 25 degrees centigrade temperature to give a orthonitrophenol, mix of orthonitrophenol plus paranitrophenol. Then mononitration of the toluene can be carried out at 55 degrees centigrade to give a mix of 60% of orthonitrotoluene, 4% of metanitrotoluene, and 36% of paranitrotoluene. So these reactions can be carried out at 55 degrees centigrade temperatures. And this is nitrobenzene, and the nitration of the nitrobenzene can be carried out at 80 to 90 degrees centigrade with the same nitrating reagent to give a metadinitrobenzene. So these are the four examples of the nitration. In all the four examples, the nature of the nitrating reagents are the same, and all are the examples of the mononitration, but the temperatures are different. Why these temperatures are different to proceed this nitration? We know that that temperature, it means activation energy is required for the different aromatic system is different, and which is based on functional group present in the molecule. We know that the first example, acetanilide. Acetanilide is a strongly activating group. It requires a very less reaction, very less energy to proceed the reaction. Then second one is phenolic OH group. Phenolic OH group is also a strongly activating group. it also requires a release energy to process the reaction. So that's why these reactions can be carried out at 20 to 25 degrees centigrade temperature. And toluene is a moderately active group. So it requires more energy than compared to acetanilide as well as phenol. So that's why these reactions can be carried out at 55 degrees centigrade temperature. And we know that nitro group is a weakly activating group. It means it requires more and more energy than compared to acetanilide as well as phenol and toluene. So that's why these reactions can be carried out at 80 to 90 degrees centigrade temperature. So third factor is affecting on the nitration unit process is the functional group present in the aromatic system. So we can't go for the mononitration of aniline. We know that aniline is a more reactive, and we have to decrease the reactivity of aniline by acetylation. So that's why even though that nitration of acetanilide can be carried out below 10 degrees centigrade, or that reactions can be carried out at 0 to 5 degrees centigrade. So third factor is affecting on the nitration is the functional group present on the aromatic system, aromatic compound, or compound to be nitrated. Nitration unit process is one of the most important unit process for the manufacture of many dye intermediates, pharmaceuticals, explosives, agrochemicals, just like a pesticide, insecticide, fungicide, herbicides, etc. They also serve the useful intermediate for the preparation of other compounds, particularly amines, which are prepared by reaction of the nitro compounds. So first example is the nitration of benzene. This nitration can be carried out first at 25 to 30 degrees centigrade and then 60 to 70 degrees centigrade temperatures. So this is the exothermic reaction. So intercooling tube should be there, and these reactions can be carried out in iron, cast iron vessels, and RPM of that reactor should not be less than 60. And first we have to maintain 25 to 30 degrees centigrade, and then we have to increase 60 to 70 degrees centigrade temperatures. And with the help of the with the help of the density of the nitrobenzene layer, we can check the completion of these reactions. And nitrobenzene is used in the manufacturing of aniline, phenyl hydrazine, benzene, methionic acid, etc. Now, nitration of the nitrobenzene can be carried out with the help of 23% nitric acid and 67% of sulfuric acid. And these reactions also carried out in a cast iron reactors. And metadinitrobenzene can be used to prepare paraphenylene diamine. And that paraphenylene diamine can be used in the preparation of many dyes, as for example, bismuth brown G. Now, nitration of acetanilide, we already discussed that. We know that acetanilide group is a very reactive group. It requires very less energy. So that's why these reactions can be carried out below 10 degrees centigrade temperature. So to give an ortho substituted derivative as well as para substituted derivatives. So hydrolysis of the corresponding anilide group into amino compounds. So that can be used in the intermediates. Now, nitration of the naphthalene. So mononitration of the naphthalene can be carried out with the help of the nitric acid and sulfuric acid at 50 to 60 degrees centigrade to give a 1 nitronaphthalene. If you go for the higher temperature, to give a disubstituted derivative of 1,5-dinitronaphthalene and 1,9-dinitronaphthalene. And 1 nitronaphthalene can be used to prepare alpha naphthyl amine. But we know that alpha naphthyl amine is a after alpha naphthalamine and beta naphthalamine, both are the carcinogenic compounds. So we have to take care about the carcinogenic activity of alpha naphthalamine as well as beta naphthalamine. Now, nitration of the acetanilide, anthracene, the nitration of mononitration of anthracene can be carried out at very less temperature, that is 0 degrees centigrade temperature, to give a 9 nitro anthracene. Similarly, if you go for the dinitration of the anthracene, this dinitration can be carried out even at 15 to 20 degrees centigrade temperature to give a 9-10 dinitro anthracene. Now, if you go for the oxidation of anthracene with the help of the nitric acid at 60 to 70 degrees centigrade to give a anthraquinone. And we know that anthraquinone can be used to prepare a VAT dyes. and anthraquinone can also be used as a bulk repellent for these seeds. Now, nitration of the anthraquinone. If we go for the mononitration of anthraquinone at 50 to 60 degrees centigrade temperature to give a 1-nitro-anthraquinone, and if we go for the dinitration of the anthraquinone with the help of the concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid at 80 to 90 degrees centigrade to give 1,5-dinitro-anthraquinone as well as 1,8-dinitro-anthraquinone, and they are used as a anthraquinone diced. Nitration of the chlorobenzene, we already discussed about the nitration of the chlorobenzene, and this mononitration can be carried out at 40 to 80 degrees centigrade temperature to give orthonitro chlorobenzene and paranitro chlorobenzenes. So nomenclatures are over mistaken. So both this orthonitro and paranitro chlorobenzene can be used to prepare a corresponding aniline derivatives by ammonolysis. Now, nitration of aminophenols. Now, we know that these aminophenol consists two reactive groups. If we go for the reactions of phenol with nitric acid, so it may go for the oxidation reaction. So it is very difficult to proceed nitration reactions of orthoaminophenol. Why? Orthoaminophenol consists two reactive groups. One is aniline group, another one is the phenolic OH group. So before proceeding the nitration, we have to protect the amino group as well as phenolic OH group by converting it into benzyl oxazole with the FOS gene. And then we have to go for the nitration reaction to give a nitro derivative. And then again, deprotection can be carried out with the help of the hydrolysis to give a 2-aminophenol. And this is the most important intermediates in the manufacturing of diced. Now, nitration of aniseline, also aniseline. Now we know that nitration of orthoaniseline can be carried out with the help of the 15% nitric acid first, and then reaction can be carried out with the help of 95% sulfuric acid at 0 to 5 degrees centigrade temperature to give 2-methoxy-6-nitroaniline, and it is used as a azo as well as diazo component. Now, nitration of the alpha naphthol. Generally, nitration of the alpha naphthol can be carried out with the help of the mixer acid to give a 2-nitro-1-naphthol, 4-nitro-1-naphthol, as well as 2,4-dinitro-1-naphthol. Now, 2-nitro-1-naphthol-naphthol, 4-nitro-1-naphthol, 2,4-dinitro-1-naphthol, and their corresponding nitro amino derivatives are used as diced intermediates. Now, nitration of the 2-naphthol, that is with the help of the nitric acid in presence of a mercuric salt to give a 1-nitro-2-naphthol, and it is used in the preparation of diced. Nitration of the toluene. So nitration of the toluene can be carried out at 55 degrees centigrade. We know that toluene group is a moderately active group, so it requires more energy than compared to phenol and acetanilide to give a mix of 60% orthonitro, 4% is a metasubstituted, and 36% is a parasubstituted derivative of toluene. Now, applications as an orthotoluidine, metatoluidine, and paratoluidine by reduction of orthonitro, metanitro, and paranitro toluenes. The next one is the trinitration of the toluene to give a TNT. And we already know that we are very familiar with the TNT. TNT can be used as an emitol with the mixes of ammonium nitrate, and TNT can be recognized as an emitol, and it can be used as a molecular explosive. So trinitro toluene can be synthesized by treating toluene with the fuming nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid at 110 degrees centigrade. We can also synthesize by another route by using concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid, but that reactions require more temperature. PNM, trinitromethane. This is the another explosive, and to prepare tetranitromethane, it requires 6 moles of the nitric acid TNG, trinitroglycerin. Now this nitration can be carried out at a very lower temperature. This nitration can be carried out at a lower temperatures with the help of the concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid, and it requires to we have to maintain temperature 2 to 3 degrees centigrade temperature, and TNG can also be used as a explosive, and mixes of nitroglycerin and cellulose can be recognized as a dynamite. Now another examples of the nitration unit as a RDX. We know that RDX, we know that it can also be recognized as a cyclonite, and the full form of RDX is a research department explosive. Why it is called as a RDX? Okay, we know that RDX is a powerful explosive, and the reactivity of this RDX is more than the TNT. TNT is also a more powerful explosive, but the reactivity of RDX is a more than TNT. So safety point of view, it can be categorized as a special category as a research department explosive. So that's why trinitro derivative of hexamethylene tetramine, or we can say cyclonite, can also be recognized as a RDX, and it is used as a powerful explosives. Another explosive is PPN, and that can be synthesized by pentaerythritol, tetranitration of pentaerythritol, and this pentaerythritol can be synthesized by using aldol condensation between acetaldehyde and formaldehyde, and then cross kinesidor action with the help of alkali to give a pentaerythritol. And PTN, that is pentaerythritol tetranitrate, can also be used as an explosive. The next one is 2,4-dinitrophenol. So how to prepare 2,4-dinitrophenol? First of all, dinitration of the chlorobenzene, and followed by the hydrolysis reaction for the by NaOH to give a 2,4-dinitrophenol, and that 2,4-dinitrophenol can be used as a plant to control the plant pest as well as herbs. Next one is the 2,4-dinitro-orthocyclohexylphenol, and this can be used against leaf hoppers as well as aphid. And 2,4-dinitro-orthocyclohexylphenol can be synthesized by the condensation reaction between phenol and cyclohexane, and followed by the dinitration. We already aware that how to prepare artificial musk. We already know that musk is nothing but the kasturi. Okay, that is natural perfume, and we can synthesize that musk by nitration unit process. So polynitro derivative of tertiary butyl group of benzene derivative, which is very resembled to musk, and examples are musk xylene, musk ketones. So how to prepare musk xylene? So first we have to go for the Friedel-Crafts alkylations of metaxylene with the help of tertiary butyl bromide, and anhydrous condition is required for this Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, and then followed by the acetylation, then followed by the trinitration to give us musk xylene. If you introduce a acetyl group, and then dinitration to give a musk ketone. So they are used as a artificial musk, and they are used in the perfume as well as soap industry. The another one is the musk amrate. It can also be synthesized from the metacrassols, and this is known as O-methylation. So O-methylation, it means methylation of the phenolic OH group with the help of dimethyl sulfate and NaOH, and then alkylation reactions, and then nitration to give a musk amrate. And this is more stronger than previous one, and they are used in the soap industry. 2,4-dinitroanisole, and this 2,4-dinitroanisole can be carried out by dinitration of the orthoanisole, and this 2,4 DNA can be used against bed bugs, cockroaches, as well as poultry lice. This is another herbicides, and this is the fungicide that is from the carbazole. If you go for the sulfodisulfonation and then nitration to give a tetranitrocarbazole, it can be used as a fungicide. So this is the first unit process, is the nitration, So we know that what is nitration? To introduce one or more nitro group into organic reacting molecule, that is known as nitration. And with the help of the nitration, we can synthesize many explosives, perfumes, as well as dye intermediates and many more things. Now, second unit process is the sulfonation. Now, what is sulfonation? To introduce one or more SO2X group into organic reacting molecule, that is known as sulfonation. To introduce SO3H, SO3Na, or SO2Cl into organic reacting molecule is known as sulfonation. Then sulfation, to introduce SO4 linkage between two carbon atoms, that can recognize as a sulfation. So sulfonation, and what is sulfonation? To introduce one or more SO2X group, or we can say SO3H, SO3Na, or SO2Cl group into organic reacting molecule, that is known as sulfonation. And sulfation, it means to introduce SO4 linkage between two carbon, that can be recognized as a sulfation. Now again, sulfonating agents and sulfating reagents agents. Now first, we can use only sulfuric acid, sulfur trioxide gas, as a sulfonating reagent. We know that sulfur trioxide is a gas, and pyridine, dioxane, these are the solvent. We can use sulfur trioxide gas in pyridine. We can also use sulfur trioxide in dioxane. We can also use sulfur trioxide in water, and we are using that as a sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid is nothing but the sulfur trioxide gas passes through water, that can be recognized as a sulfuric acid. Okay, and we are using sulfuric acid in various forms. As for example, we are using 25 to 35% weight by weight of sulfuric acid as a battery acid, and that battery acid we are using in the automobile batteries. Then tower acid, the concentration of that sulfur trioxide gas near at about 65%. Then chamber acid, the concentration of that sulfur trioxide gas is near at about 75%. Oil of vitriol, about 90%. And absolute sulfuric acid near at about 98%. So that sulfuric acid is nothing but the sulfur trioxide gas in water form. Then we can also use oleum as a sulfur trioxide plus concentrated sulfuric acid. We can also use as a sulfur trioxide plus ammonia, that is sulfonamide. And sulfur trioxide gas in hydrochloric acid, that can be recognized as a chlorosulfonic acid. That is, that can be used for the chlorosulfonation. So these are the functions as a sulfur trioxide gas. It should be sulfur dioxide. It should not be a mixed acid. So in case of the sulfur dioxide plus water plus oxygen to give a sulfur trioxide, sulfurous acid and SO2Cl, then metanilic, sulfoyl alkylating reagent, that is sulfomethylating reagents, that is sodium salt of the hydroxymethane sulfonic acid, sodium salt of aminomethane sulfonic acid, sulfoethylating reagents. These are the different sulfonating reagents. Now, reaction mechanism of this sulfonation. So, simplest example of the sulfonation unit process is the sulfonation of benzene to benzene sulfonic acid. Now, the reaction mechanism of the sulfonation also consists of three steps. So, we know that sulfonation is a electrophilic substitution reactions. We know that first step of the reaction mechanism is to convert into sulfur trioxide gas. And sulfur trioxide gas is a neutral electrophile. It is an electrophilic substitution reaction. Sulfonation is an electrophilic substitution reaction. It means one hydrogen of benzene can be substituted by this electrophile. So first step of this sulfonation unit process reaction mechanism is to form a sulfur trioxide. So here, 2 moles of this sulfuric acid can be used to prepare sulfur trioxide. So 1 molecule of sulfuric acid can be used as an acid. Another molecule of the sulfuric acid can be used as a base. So one can donate a proton to form a bisulfate, and another molecules of sulfuric acid can gain a proton, and which dissociates into sulfur trioxide and hydronium ion. So this is the first step of the reaction mechanism of the sulfonation. Second step of the attack of the electrophile to the aromatic system and to form a sulfobenzonimine and delocalization of the positively charged, and finally deprotonation to give a benzene sulfonic acid. So this is the reaction mechanism of the sulfonation unit process. Now, different functional groups are present in on a reactive system. Is sulfonic acid group is there, so we have to go for the metadiuretic. Nitro is a metadiuretic, toluene group is an ortho and para, and fluoro is an ortho and para reactive group. Now, sulfonation of the aliphatic compounds. Generally, nitration or sulfonation of the aliphatic compounds can be carried out at a very low temperatures. As for example, N-butyl alcohol. This chlorosulfonation can be carried out only at 10 to 20 degrees centigrade temperature. Sulfonation of lauryl alcohol can be carried out at 30 degrees centigrade, and sulfonation of dimethyl ether can be carried out at 40 degrees centigrade temperatures. Now, aromatic sulfonation can be carried out at higher temperature than compared to our aliphatic sulfonation of aliphatic compounds. As for example, monosulfonation of benzene to give a benzene sulfonic acid, and these reactions can be carried out at 80 degrees centigrade temperatures. And if we increase the temperature to give a benzene metal disulfonic acid. So we already discussed about the nitration or sulfonation of the benzene. So monosulfonation can be carried out at 80 degrees centigrade temperature with the help of the concentrated sulfuric acid. And if you go for the fusion reaction with caustic at 180 to 200 degrees centigrade temperature and acidify with the hydrochloric acid to give a phenol. Similarly, resorcinol from metal disulfonic acid. Okay, so here if we use oleum, we can use 8% oleum, and that reactions can be carried out at 20 degrees centigrade temperature. Now, benzene sulfonic acid and benzene metal disulfonic acid are used in the corresponding amino as well as hydroxyl compounds. Next one is the sulfonation of the toluene. Okay, if you go for the sulfonation of the toluene at lower temperature to give a ortho substituted derivative as a sulfonic acid, and if we increase the temperature to give a para substituted sulfonic acid derivatives, and they are used in the corresponding Crassus derivatives. Now, this is chlorosulfonation of the toluene. And chlorosulfonation of the toluene can be carried out at lower temperature, generally 0 to 5 degrees centigrade temperature. Now, ortho-toluene sulfonyl chloride can be used to prepare saccharin, and para-toluene sulfonyl chloride can be used in the preparation of chloramine T and dichloramine T. Now, sulfonation of the benzene. This is picric acid. So, how to synthesize picric acid? We can't prepare picric acid directly by trinitration of phenol. Either we have to go for the disulfonation of phenol, or first of all, we have to go for the dinitration of the chlorobenzene, then substitution by sodium hydroxide as a phenolic OH group. So two routes are available to prepare picric acid. So first step is disulfonation to give a phenol 2,4 disulfonic acid, and then reaction with the concentrated nitric acid to convert into picric acid. So why? So we know that phenolic OH group is a very reactive group, and if we introduce free nitro group, and due to the explosive effect of this trinitrophenol, we can't prepare picric acid directly from phenol. So we have to go for the either disulfonation of the phenol or dinitration of the chlorobenzene. Now we are using this picric acid as a reagent and explosive. So there are three nitro groups and one phenolic OH group. So overall activity of picric acid is acidic in nature. We know that phenols are weakly acidic in nature, and the presence of the three electron withdrawing group in a symmetrical position. So overall effect of this picric acid is acidic in nature, and the picric, this word comes from the picrost. The taste of this trinitrophenol is bitter in nature. So that's why it can be recognized as a picric acid. Now, sulfonation of the naphthalene. The sulfonation of the naphthalene can be carried out with the help of the sulfuric acid, And if these reactions can be carried out at 80 degrees centigrade temperature to give a naphthalene 1 sulfonic acid, and if these reactions can be carried out at 160 degrees centigrade temperature to give a naphthalene 2 sulfonic acid. In case of the nitration, if we increase the temperature to give a mono to disulfide derivative, but in case of this naphthalene, if we go for the sulfonation of the naphthalene at 80 degrees centigrade temperature to give a naphthalene 1 sulfonic acid, and if we increase the temperature to give a naphthalene 2 sulfonic acid. So why this is the difference between these two? So we know that sulfonation reactions is a reversible in nature. At lower temperature, only more canonical structure is possible at the position number 1. And if we increase the temperature, so deactivation of deattachment of the sulfonic acid group from the position number 1, and more canonical structure is available at the position number 2. So that's why to form an naphthalene 2 sulfonic acid. So these are the different sulfonation of naphthalene 1 sulfonic acid and naphthalene 2 sulfonic acid. And this is the sulfonation of the alpha naphthol. This is the sulfonation of beta naphthol to prepare corrosion acid scrapper acid. These are the examples of the anthraquinone. Now, this is the synthetic gum as a sulfonated polystyrene. Now, our sulfonation unit process can also be used in the preparation of alcohol. And we know that there are many routes are available, that is for natural route and synthetic route. We can synthesize, or we can prepare ethanol by molasses route, that is fermentation route, or we can synthesize, that is with the help of direct hydration as well as indirect hydration process. So we know that ethanol can be used as a solvent. It can also be used in the preparation of acetaldehyde, acetic anhydride, as well as in as a fuel. Isopropyl alcohol, now it is a more demanded in our pandemic situation of the corona. So isopropyl can also be used, can be prepared from propylene, saccharin. It can also be synthesized by autotoluene sulfonyl chloride with the help of the our chlorosulfonations of the toluene. And finally, ammonolysis, oxidation, and acidify, and then cyclization to give up saccharin. And saccharin can be used as a sweetening agent, and it has no biological action with our body.
Sir, sorry to disturb you. Just 5 to 10 minutes left.
Okay, can I continue? Sir, can I continue?
Okay, 5 minutes.
Okay, fine. Then another one is the chloramine T and dichloramine T, that these are the antiseptic compounds. Another one is tolbutamide. You know very well about tolbutamide. We can use tolbutamide as a hypoglycemic agent, and that hypoglycemic acid can be used to reduce the glucose from our blood. So it can be taken by diabetic patient. Sulfathiazole, these are the sulfur drugs, can also be prepared by sulfonation unit process. This is the detergents. This is the wetting agents. So with the help of this sulfonation unit process, we can prepare the IG1T. Now another unit process is the halogenation. Now what is halogenation? We know that to introduce one or more halogen atom into organic reacting molecule, that is known as halogenation. We already known that chlorination, bromination, iodination, fluorination, these are the different halogenations. Now, what is chlorination? To introduce one or more chlorine atom into organic reacting molecule, that is known as halogenation, that is known as chlorination. Chlorination can be carried out in a different ways, by using only chlorine, by using a hydrochloric acid, by using sulfur, another way. So first one is the chlorination of the methane, and it should not be 400 to 400, 500 degrees centigrade. These reactions can be carried out in the presence of electromagnetic radiation to give a methyl chloride, dimethyl, dichloromethane, and chloroform and carbon tetrachloride. We know that methyl chloride can be used as an alkylating reagent. It can be also used as a refrigerant. Dichloromethane can be used as a solvent, and chloroform can be used as a general anesthetic as well as fluorocarbons. And CCl4 can be used as a dry cleaning agent as well as a solvent, as well as. Now, chlorination of the ethylene. Chlorination of the ethylene can be carried out in presence of apicialry to give ethylene dichloride and dehydrohalogenation to give a vinyl chloride. And we know that vinyl chloride can be used to prepare a PVC plastic, as a PVC pipes, etc. And as a good diluent for the production of butyl rubber and as well as refrigerant. Chlorination of benzene. And we know that chlorination of benzene can be carried out in presence of apicialry to give a chlorobenzene. And chlorobenzene is a parent compound to prepare DDT, dinitrochlorobenzene, and many more. We can also prepare paradichlorobenzene, and that can be used as a deodorant by the dichlorination of the benzene, or we can say monochlorination of chlorobenzene. Then chlorination of the solvent to give a benzyl chloride, benzo trichloride, and from benzyl chloride, we can prepare benzyl alcohol to benzaldehyde, and from benzo trichloride to give a benzoic acid. Now, chlorination of the xylenes can be carried out at 10 to 15 degrees centigrade temperature. Chlorination of the naphthalene can be carried out at 100 to 140 degrees centigrade temperature. And if you go for the vapor phase chlorination of naphthalene to give alpha as well as beta chloronaphthalene. This is the chlorination of anthraquinone derivatives. Now, this is the vinyl chloride. How to prepare vinyl chloride? We know that acetylene is a very reactive group, and chlorination of acetylene gas can be carried out with the help of the hydrochloric acid to give a polyvinyl chloride. This is substitution reactions, benzene to chlorobenzene. This is the conversion of benzaldehyde to benzyl chloride as well as benzoyl chloride by chlorination process. Chlorination with ethanol chloride, we can convert any phenolic OH group as well as alcohol to halogen atom. We can synthesize ethyl chloride from the ethanol by treating ethanol with the ethanol chloride. So these are the different chlorinating agents. Sulfural chloride, this is the aniline chloride, aniline hydrochloride with the sulfural chloride to give a 2,4 dichlorotoluene finally. Chlorination with the phosphorus chlorides. If you go for the conversion of any acid into acid chloride by treating it with PCl5. If you go for the sodium salt of the benzoic acid to convert into benzoyl chloride, and this is very reactive. This is sulfur monohalide, reactions of sulfur disulfide. This is Sandmeyer reaction. This is well-known examples for the aromatic amines, primary aromatic amine, that is Sandmeyer reaction and Gaterman reactions. Bromination can be carried out with the help of the bromine as well as brominating reagent.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, we have limited time.
Okay, fine. Now we can.
Sir, thank you very much for a very good chemical reactions, mechanisms, and you have delivered nitration, sulfonation, halogenations, as well as also delivered unit processes as well as unit operations from starting very good all reagents and chemical processes, temperature, pressure, conditions, all you have all you mentioned in the reactions as well as discuss with our students and audience. You have delivered so much raw materials for nitration reactions. That is very good. All the raw materials like benzene, naphthalene, alpha naphthol, beta naphthol, acetaldehyde, chlorobenzene, nitrosan is very good for our students. As well as you have discussed unit operations also, as well as you discuss there are uses of applications like TNMM and trinitroglycerin, etc. As well as you all cover the all materials, applications is very good, and overall all the informations you are sharing with us, that is good for our students. I hope that during this lockdown period, they have discussed, they have learned a lot of more from your side, and I heartily thankful to you for delivering a wonderful speech. And on behalf of RNGPID, I once again I also thanks to you for your wonderful and technical concepts which you have to discuss with us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ramesh sir, as well as organizers of this webinar to give me a chance for discussing with engineering students. Thank you very much. Any questions, Ramesh sir, please, from students? Any questions?
From the students, any questions from the students? Sir, right now, and no more questions from the students.
Okay.
We have wonderful, wonderful technical sessions, and clear the concepts of the all organic mechanisms.
Thank you very much again, Dr. Ramesh sir, for nice cooperation from your organization. Thank you very much.
Sir, I wish you come at our college when this lockdown period is over, and deliver a whole speech for our students.
That is more interactive session. Okay, Ramesh sir. That is more benefit to students.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much.